We'll now call this meeting of the Jacksonville City Council to order. I want to thank everyone who's come out for the meeting tonight. We've got quite a packed house. And also thank those for viewing in on G10 television this evening. We're going to start our meeting tonight by having the Pledge of Allegiance led by Councilmember Bob Warden, followed by the invocation by our City Attorney John Carter. Please rise.
Please join me in our pledge. Pledge
allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Heavenly Father, as always, we pause to give you thanks. To give you thanks for your presence in our lives and for the benefits and blessings you bestow upon each of us individually and as the city of Jacksonville. We recognize and pray for each person who will be recognized this evening and for each cause for which a proclamation will be presented. But we especially call out and recognize the suicide prevention month that is upon us because of its relevance to us as a nation and also especially to our military. Each of us is on a journey that at times is most difficult, but life is a gift from you. And we pray that you would empower and enlighten each of us so that we could be a support, an encouragement to those who may be struggling in those valleys of life. We do pray, as always, for our military. Give thanks for their service here and around the world, and pray for their anxious families. And as always, we pray for our mayor and for our council, that your guidance and your direction would be with them. All of this we ask in your holy name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Nice prayer.
Council, each member has a copy of the proposed agenda for tonight's meeting, and I would entertain a motion to adopt, but also include as a add-on, which will be agenda item number 4 under non-consent items for appointments to the Tourism Development Authority.
So moved.
Second.
Okay, any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Okay. Our agenda has been adopted. So now we have some presentations, and I'm going to come around front here. You do such a magnificent job of laying everything out there, so it's so easy for me. Thank you. I'd like to, right now, we got a presentation tonight. This is going to be with our Fleet Reserve Association, branch number 208, for our Freedom Fountain. And I'd like to ask those members if you would come forward. We have Bill Boggs, who's the branch president, Mark Rogers, who's the secretary, and my old friend Bill Hemingway, who's still taking care of the money. Yes, sir. We're honored this evening to have the leadership of the Fleet Reserve Association, Branch 208, in attendance for a special presentation to the city for our Freedom Fountain.
A little slower than I used to be. Thank you. Mayor, thank you very much.
Yes, sir. Why don't y'all fall in here behind.
Mayor Phillips and the City Council, the Association, Fleet Reserve Association, was formed in 1927 and chartered by a national charter. We opened our branch here in 1945. I wasn't here then. However, I've been a member 60 years, and I feel very dedicated to the Fleet Reserve Association, the things they've done for the Marine Corps, Coast Guard, and of course the Navy. I'm Navy myself, and most of these gentlemen up here are former Marines, retired Marines. But we had a piece of property out in this near the police pistol range. You know where it was. And several years ago, we sold it, so we have a little bit of money, and we've been trying to donate to worthy causes in the community, because that money came to us through the community here in Jacksonville and Onslow County. We used to have a bingo game out there every Sunday, and that's how we paid our bills and paid the property off and built a building. At any rate, the fountain came along, and I was really grateful for Mr. Bittner and his crew up there. And of course, we can't forget about the doctor over here. He's the one that put this thing all together. But we're very proud of it, and it certainly reflects in the community, the military, to the military, what the community feels about the military presently here and in the past. We've given this speech $5,000. Phillips, Mayor Phillips, we appreciate the opportunity to give it. And frankly, I think that a lot of the other organizations in the community might want to be thought about too when they make a donation. But we do appreciate very much your recognizing the branch tonight. And we have a group of ladies also that are auxiliary, and they're part of that money belongs to them as a result. But we again thank you for recognizing us tonight, and it's a pleasure to be here and make that presentation.
Thank you, Bill.
Thank you.
Appreciate it, folks. This is folks like you have made this a reality, being able to put the Freedom Fountain out here. And we all know what a wonderful sight that is to come into the downtown area of Jacksonville here and see that lit up at night. And we all know what it signifies, right? And it's an honor to all those military people that have served this country, that have passed through our community. This is our offering to them to always memorialize their presence here in the community. But I would like to present a certificate of appreciation and recognition to Fleet Reserve Association number branch 208, the branch president. I'm going to give it to the president. Okay? This is for dedication and commitment to the City of Jacksonville and the Freedom Fountain, presented by the Jacksonville City Council on this 22nd day of September 2015. Thank you so much. Great job. Thank you for coming, guys. Appreciate it. For the next presentation this evening, I'd like to ask Dawn Rochelle, the Executive Director of Onslow County Partnership for Children, to come forward. And anybody that you have with you?
Yes, the task force.
Your staff. And your helpers.
I do. Good to see you. It's a community effort, right?
Yes, it is. Yeah, absolutely. Hey,
hello. How you doing?
Bob? Craig, how you doing? Chief? Well, right there, perfect. Okay, that's right. Suicide has become the leading cause of death in Onslow County for residents under the age of 55. The Onslow County Suicide Prevention Task Force was recently formed to help address this issue. A proclamation has been requested recognizing September as Suicide Prevention Awareness Month. And at this time, I will read the proclamation that has been prepared. Whereas suicide is one of the most disruptive and tragic losses a family and community can experience. And whereas suicide has become the leading cause of death in Onslow County for residents under the age of 55. And whereas suicide prevention awareness, education, and action does save lives. And whereas the Onslow County Suicide Prevention Task Force was recently founded to raise public awareness, align community efforts, educate, advocate, and leverage existing resources, all recognized as vital to preventing the further suffering and loss of life. And whereas our community must actively develop collaborative partnerships and resources to increase awareness of this tragic problem, destigmatize the perception of individuals and families affected by suicide, and seek to develop and implement dynamic, integrated measures to prevent suicide. Now, therefore, I, Sammy Phillips, Mayor of the City of Jacksonville, do hereby proudly proclaim Suicide Prevention Month, Awareness Month in September. And I call upon all citizens, educators, community agencies, faith groups, mental and physical health care professionals, elected leaders, and businesses to join us in recognizing suicide as a complex but preventable public health issue in our community. And thank you very much for all your efforts. And
thank
I'll
you.
Give you a moment to speak if you would like.
Thank you. We appreciate the city's recognition of this really public health cause, as we've called it. A lot of folks only recognize it as a mental health issue. And we wanted to come together as a community in response, in particular to the adolescents that took their lives earlier this year. Of course, when we begin to look at the data, we know that those deaths are only reflective of many more who think about it, many more who consider it. And we need to come together as a community to leverage the existing resources, knowing that there may not be other resources that come to our community. And so we know that in Onslow County, and certainly the city of Jacksonville, we have the brain power here. We have folks who are willing to offer services and to leverage resources, and many times it's just the coordinating and the recognizing that this is an issue in our community. So thank you so much, and I appreciate Mr. Carter leading the prayer with recognizing this as an issue in our community. Thank you.
Dawn, would you mind introducing your team?
I would. I'd be happy to. These are some of the folks. We have about 25 different agencies that are represented. Those represented here tonight are Craig Wagner, who is the president of United Way of Onslow County. We also have Bob Williams, who is recognized and representing the Boys and Girls Club, and as well as the Board of Education for Onslow County. We also have Anna Hurst, who's representing Bryn Mawr Hospital with us. Kathleen Holbrook, who is representing one of many things, but our Child Advocacy Center of Onslow County. And Chief Mike Yaniro, who has certainly been a guiding force, is also a board member for the Partnership for Children.
Thank you, Dawn.
Thank you so much.
Next, I'd like to recognize a proclamation for Minority Enterprise Development Week. And I know I have Lorette Lagon who's here from the Chamber of Commerce, and you also have some very distinguished guests with you tonight also, if you'd have them come forward.
Legan.
I'm sorry. Thank you all for coming out tonight. Legan.
Thank you.
I got it. It's committed to memory. I'm sorry. In recognition of Minority Enterprise Development Week and to encourage all residents to recognize the importance of small and minority-owned businesses, a proclamation was requested by the Jacksonville Onslow Chamber of Commerce, and I am so proud to be able to stand here tonight and read this proclamation that has been prepared for this special occasion. Whereas the Jacksonville Onslow Chamber of Commerce will observe Minority Enterprise Development Week September 28th through October 2nd, 2015, and whereas at a time when many Americans are facing extraordinary economic challenges, supporting the development of minority-owned enterprises will help accelerate the revitalization of our economy. And whereas the goal of the Chamber's Minority Business Services Committee is to expand the growth of our community's small and minority-owned businesses. And whereas Minority Enterprise Development Week's theme, Linking the Stories, offers increased opportunity to commemorate the tremendous value that minority entrepreneurs and their employees bring to our community, our history, and our economy. And whereas the Jacksonville Onslow Chamber of Commerce and the Chamber's Minority Business Services Committee will honor a Minority Business Entrepreneur of the Year and the Linda L. Richardson Minority Business Advocate of the Year. Now, therefore, I, Sammy Phillips, the mayor of the city of Jacksonville, do hereby proudly proclaim the week of September 28th through October 2nd, 2015, as Minority Enterprise Development Week in the city of Jacksonville, and I encourage all citizens to join with me in honoring the important role small and minority businesses have in our society. Furthermore, I commend the men and women whose integrity, ingenuity, and innovative spirit contribute to the free enterprise system on which the American economy was founded, and I invite all citizens to celebrate the significance of linking the stories. Ms. Legan? Ms. Legan?
Thank you, Sammy. Thank you, and I'm going to hand this over to the chair of our Minority Business Services Committee, Adrienne James.
Thank you. Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, council members. It's an honor to be able to come yet again and receive a proclamation. The city is always behind us, supporting us in the efforts that we do as the chamber and as the committee. We work diligently to try to make a difference in this committee in which we are so, or this community that we are so privileged to live in. We have a lot lined up for next week. Monday, we're going to start over at the Montfort Point Association on Bryn Mawr Road with our luncheon. We invite you to come out. On Wednesday, we've partnered with the Richlands Chamber of Commerce. We're going to do a walking tour of Richlands and take a view of the museum. On Thursday, we're going to be at the USO. We're going to have an all-white soiree. If you do not have all-white, you are still welcome to come. Come. No matter what color you have, you are welcome to attend the soiree. We are going to have a good time. We're going to have a panelist of what we call our first trailblazers, our African Americans that made a difference in Onslow County. They're going to be a panelist there, and they're going to be answering some questions that Valentina Wilson from Channel 12 will be asking and everything. So we do invite you to come out to attend that. And then on Friday, we're going to finish with our familiarization tour, better known as FAM tour, for those that are familiar with Onslow County tourism. We know that we can
can't value what we don't realize we have. And so that tour has been designed to take us around Jacksonville and Onslow County to show us some markers, the Montfort Point Museum, different things that African Americans have contributed to Onslow County and Jacksonville as a whole. So we hope that you will come out and join us this week as we are looking forward to having a good time. You can call the chamber at 910-347-3141, ask for Lorette or Anna, and they'll be more than happy to take your money and get you on the RSVP list. And so we look forward to a great week, and we thank you all in advance for coming out and supporting us. And as always, we say thank you. All right.
Absolutely. I'm Adrian, second year now as the chair, and she's also on our board. I have Donald Carter over here. We have Anna Davin. I've got Tamara Matthews, Diana Barnes, Naomi Thompson, good Lord, Cindy Edwards, and of course, Commissioner Millionaire Williams, and Dr. Lingle just showed up, so.
Just a pretty face.
How many years now has that been?
This is our 10th year.
10th year, okay. That's, we miss Linda. She was always a presence, wasn't she?
Yes.
Next, I'd like to have a proclamation I'd like to present for the I Filled Her Shoes Breast Cancer Awareness Week. And this time I have Sheila Hadley and some members of the Leather and Lace Motorcycle Club. They're going to join us again this year. What do we do? Fall off our motorcycle? Okay. Okay.
Curve
one. Yeah, I was going to say you got a little bit more assistance this year than you had last year. But thank you very much for coming back again this year.
Thank you.
This is our fifth year.
Yes. Oh, well, we really appreciate what you do for your community. I do have a few words to say here. Leather and Lace Motorcycle Club is sponsoring the I Filled Her Shoes. It's a 1 mile walk. Fundraising event where men will wear women's shoes. Oh boy, oh my! To symbolize that they too can get breast cancer and that the disease is not just one that solely occurs in women. The event will be held on Sunday, October 4th, 2015, at New River Harley-Davidson, starting at noon, and the proceeds will be directed to the John Hopkins Avon Foundation Breast Center. Thank you so much for what you're doing, and I'm privileged to read this proclamation at this time. Whereas breast cancer is not gender biased, and attention is being called to the research currently being conducted by John Hopkins Avon Foundation Breast Center, in 2015, an estimated 294,410 new cases of breast cancer were expected to be diagnosed in the United States alone. Of those cases, 2,350 new cases of breast cancer will be diagnosed in men in 2015. And whereas in North Carolina, the projected new cases of breast cancer have risen by 32%, approximately 10% are male breast cancer, and 196 cases are in Onslow County alone. And of those, a percentage are confirmed cases of breast cancer among Marines from Camp Lejeune. And whereas Leather and Lace Motorcycle Club is sponsoring I Filled Her Shoes. This is a 1 mile walk fundraising event where men will wear women's shoes to symbolize that they too can get breast cancer, and that this disease is not just one that solely happens to women. And whereas October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and the I Feel Her Shoes Walk will be held Sunday, October 4, 2015, at New River Harley-Davidson, starting at noon. Now, therefore, I, Sammy Phillips, Mayor of the City of Jacksonville, do hereby proudly proclaim the week of October 4th through October 10th, 2015, as I Feel Her Shoes Breast Cancer Awareness Week in the City of Jacksonville. And I encourage all citizens to recognize and support this observance as an opportunity to bring awareness to this disease and the research needed to combat it. And I want to thank you all again for your fifth year of coming and bringing this to us. And would you like to say a few words?
Yes, I would. First of all, I'd like to thank you very much. This is our fifth year, and we're very excited. We can't thank you enough how much the community has supported us throughout the years. And we're hoping to support you by making you aware of what's going on as far as breast cancer, because it is true fact that not only women get breast cancer, but men do too. And it doesn't just affect when a woman has breast cancer, but it affects the whole family, and the men support that. So in honor of that, we do ask the men to, for a day, for 1 mile, to fill her shoes and walk in honor of her. And in honor of themselves, because they need to know that they can also get breast cancer. If you have never been to our event, come out on October 4th. Even if you just want to look and see what we got, there's a lot going on. We have vendors, we have the walk, and if you've never seen it, look on our Facebook, our Field of Shoes Facebook. They really do come all out for it. So it's a fun time. Again, we thank the community for supporting us, and we hope to see all of you out there October 4th, Sunday, at the Harley-Davidson New River at noon. Thank you.
John Reed. John is our fire marshal here for the City of Jacksonville Fire Services. And guess what week it is coming up? Fire Prevention Week. Well, this goes back a long ways. I remember Fire Prevention Week in elementary school. On October 4th through the 10th is Fire Prevention Week, and during this time, the Jacksonville Fire and Emergency Services works hard to educate and motivate Jacksonville's residents to keep themselves, their families, and the community safe from fire. The City of Jacksonville would like to recognize the outstanding efforts of our Fire and Emergency Services personnel with a proclamation designating October 4th through the 10th, 2015, as Fire Prevention Week in the City of Jacksonville. And I will read this proclamation that has been prepared. Whereas the City of Jacksonville is committed to ensuring the safety and security of all those living in and visiting our city, and whereas fire is a serious public safety concern both locally and nationally, and homes are the locations where people are at the greatest risk from fire, and whereas fires killed more than 3,240 people in the United States in 2013, and fire departments in the United States responded to more than 1,240,000 fires. And whereas the Jacksonville Fire personnel are dedicated to reducing the occurrence of home fires and home fire injuries through prevention and protection education. And whereas Jacksonville residents are responsive to public education measures and are able to take personal steps to increase their safety from fire, especially in their homes, And whereas the 2015 Fire Prevention Week theme, "Hear the Beep Where You Sleep." Every bedroom needs a working smoke alarm. Pretty catchy there. Effectively serves to remind us all of the simple actions we can take to keep our homes and families safe from fire during Fire Prevention Week and year-round. Now, therefore, I, Sammy Phillips, Mayor of the City of Jacksonville, do hereby proudly proclaim the week of October 4th through the 10th as Fire Prevention Week in the City of Jacksonville and throughout the City of Jacksonville. And I urge all the people of Jacksonville to protect their homes and families by heeding the important safety messages of Fire Prevention Week 2015 and to support the many public safety activities and efforts of the Jacksonville Fire Department. John, thank you very much for coming tonight and accepting this proclamation. Would you mind telling everybody when they should change the batteries in their smoke detectors? What's a good catch for doing that?
Well, you know, the seasons change every year, and when you change your clocks, we need to also change your batteries. Every 6 months, we recommend that you put in a fresh 9-volt battery and test them once a month. If you don't have a working smoke detector, and understand with the statistics that the mayor just read to you, over 3,000 lives are lost every year in homes. 80% of those could be avoided if they had working smoke detectors. So be sure that you can hear the beep where you sleep.
Craig, I should have kept you up here. Craig Wagner is the president of the United Way of Onslow County. Thank you, Craig, for joining us this evening. I do have a proclamation. The United Way of Onslow County is conducting its fall campaign, which commences on September 30th, 2015, and the donations collected are distributed to our over 30 programs and projects that are going on here in Onslow County. The city is happy to provide a proclamation in celebration of the United Way's 60th anniversary and in recognition of October as United Way of Onslow County Month. So, Craig, if you'll indulge me for a moment to do this. Whereas the vision of the United Way of Onslow County is together, united, we can inspire hope and create opportunities for a better life for all in Onslow County. And whereas United Way of Onslow County is conducting its annual fall campaign, which commences with the campaign kickoff on September 30th, 2015. And whereas the donations collected in Onslow County during the fall campaign will be distributed among community investment programs of United Way of Onslow County's partner agencies, helping almost 20,000 residents annually. And whereas United Way of Onslow County currently supports over 30 programs, projects, and local initiatives in our community, and whereas United Way of Onslow County is a locally governed 501c3 tax-exempt independent organization, and whereas since 1955, United Way of Onslow County has raised millions of dollars in support of human service agencies in our community. Now, therefore, I, Sammy Phillips, Mayor of the City of Jacksonville, do hereby proudly proclaim October 2015 as United Way of Onslow County Month, and I encourage all residents to provide support during this fundraising campaign to ensure continuance of programs of local nonprofit agencies to help those in need in our community. Through this campaign, we will all have the opportunity to live united and make a major impact in Onslow County. Remember, when we reach out a hand to one, we can influence the condition of all. And thank you, Craig, and I'll give you just a moment.
Thank you, Mayor and Council members. We are both so excited and grateful for the generosity of the citizens of this very caring community as we celebrate our 60th anniversary this year. From our programs that tackle childhood food insecurity, such as CHEW, to reducing childhood homelessness by 34% in 2.5 years, our ability to move the needle on critical issues in our community is directly related to your generosity. Thank you very much. Our campaign kicks off next Wednesday, and we appreciate your support. Thank you. Yep.
And I didn't think it could get any better. I get to do some real fun stuff here, too. That's the neat thing about being mayor. Sean, I saw you. Where are you at? Right there. Okay. I misplaced you. You and your family that you brought with you. I'm very privileged this evening. Sean is a guy that I hired. So he's one that's left over from me. They didn't get rid of all of them yet. But anyway, Sean, it makes me very happy to be able to do this tonight. Sean Marcinowski grew up on Hawaii, graduating from Kalaeho High School in 1986. Sean moved to the San Francisco Bay Area of California, where he worked as a printer and graphic designer. After moving to North Carolina, Sean attended basic law enforcement training at Coastal Carolina Community College, the best college. Did I do good? Okay. Yeah. Only because it's true. He began his law enforcement career with the Jacksonville Police Department in October 2003 and has served his entire career in the patrol division. Sean is certified as a police officer, training officer and crisis negotiator. He is a recipient of the agency's Purple Heart. Sean received this honor for injuries sustained in a November 2006 call involving a subject with a weapon. The subject relinquished a .38 caliber revolver but revealed a second weapon, displaying it in a threatening manner to officers who responded with deadly force. During the incident, Sean was seriously injured. He later returned to his full duties. His mother, Renee Clark, will be pinning a badge on him this evening. That's the one you pin. Okay. You can stick that one in your pocket. That goes on the hat, eight-point hat. Y'all don't even use them anymore, do you?
Not if we can help it.
Oh, Chief, I'm sorry.
Am I supposed to wait?
I'm going to let you hold that. Thank you. Jack was supposed to have a part in this. See, Chief, you're not the only one I've left out. All right, Jack's going to pin on him some sergeant chevrons here.
Any other way.
Corporal Jack Cohen is a fellow officer of Sean's at JPD. Another one of my brilliant hiring decisions. Right, Jack? Thank you, Jack. Now, Father is going to hold the Bible. Jerry Clark is Sean's father. And now we're going to make this all official. And if you will repeat after me, Sean. I state your name.
I, Sean Marcinowski.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and maintain.
That I will support and maintain.
The Constitution and laws of the United States.
The Constitution and laws of the United States.
And the Constitution and laws of North Carolina.
And the Constitution and law of North Carolina.
Not inconsistent therewith.
Not inconsistent therewith.
And that I will faithfully.
That I will faithfully.
Discharge the duties of my office.
Discharge the duties of my office.
As sergeant.
As sergeant.
Of the City of Jacksonville Police Department.
The City of Jacksonville Police Department.
And maintain and uphold.
And maintain and uphold.
All laws and regulations.
All laws and regulations.
Of the City of Jacksonville, North Carolina.
Of the City of Jacksonville, North
so
Carolina.
Help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you, sir.
I don't either. We'll figure it out after it's all over with, probably. We're going to have another sergeant. Paul, if you and your family would join me up front, please. Michelle, I'll let you have that. Now, the key to this is don't take out any frustrations. That is a sharp object, okay? All right. Gregory Paul Erler is a native of Beaufort, North Carolina, and he graduated from East Carteret High School in 1992. Paul completed basic law enforcement training at Carteret Community College in 1994. And began his law enforcement career at Emerald Isle Police Department. Paul signed on with the Jacksonville Police Department in December of 2010 after serving for 10 years as a police officer in Pine Knoll Shores. He has served in the Patrol Division, Community Response Team, and the Special Operations Division. He was promoted to corporal in February of 2013. Paul is a certified police training officer and holds the Advanced Law Enforcement Certification from the North Carolina Department of Justice. He is a graduate of Mountain State University, where he earned a bachelor's and a master's degree in criminal justice. And his wife, Michelle, will be pinning the badge on him tonight.
Michelle, can we have y'all step out a little bit quick? The cameras can get a little bit better shot.
Somebody's going to hold the Bible. You're going to hold the Bible. Okay. So you got a real major part in this thing. Are you ready to repeat what I say?
I will.
No,
I'm
just kidding. Right, Paul. If you would repeat after me. I state your name.
Gregory Paul Erler.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and maintain.
That I will support and maintain.
The Constitution and laws of the United States.
The Constitution and laws of the United States.
And the Constitution and laws of North Carolina.
And the Constitution and laws of North Carolina.
Not inconsistent therewith.
And not inconsistent therewith.
And that I will faithfully.
And that I will faithfully.
Discharge the duties of my office.
Discharge the duties of my office.
As sergeant.
As sergeant.
Of the City of Jacksonville Police Department.
Of the City of Jacksonville Police Department.
And maintain and uphold.
And maintain and uphold.
All laws and regulations.
All laws and regulations.
Of the City of Jacksonville, North Carolina.
Of the laws of City of Jacksonville, North Carolina.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Paul. Sergeant. They went through, if you don't mind taking a minute to
tell them a little bit. No, I'll be glad to. You know, they went through a tough process, but I think the most important thing about these two sergeants now is that They've actually kind of done the job for a while. They're both field training officers. So they were molding new officers and training new officers, which is really a big responsibility in our department. So they've kind of been doing the job for a while. Now we just made it official. So thank you very much, Mayor. You did a good job hiring. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief. And I want to just take a moment and thank every one of you. I see, look at the back of the room back here. I don't look real close because I might have some undercover people back there, but I got a lot of folks back here talking about people to stand up for each other. All those that are from the police department, please stand just a moment. Thank you for coming out in support of your fellow officers. Taught y'all well, most of you. Okay. That ends the presentations for this evening. I want to give everybody a moment. I'm going to take my time getting back up there. So if you want to make a run for the doors, now's a good time to do it. You're welcome to stay for the rest of the meeting if you wish. Now with the public comment section, I know we took the sheet up. Maybe someone came in after it was taken up. Is there anyone that wishes to speak at public comment? If so, please raise your hand. Okay, then we're going to move on to the next item of business, which is the adoption of our minutes and consent items for the evening. We have one set of minutes from the September 18th, 2015 workshop, and then we have the consent items. There's three items on the agenda tonight. Could I would entertain a motion to
move approval.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? All right. Item number four for tonight is the Jacksonville Tourism Development Authority appointments. Two seats have expired on the Jacksonville Tourism Development Authority. One of the seats must be occupied by a person representing individuals who are affiliated with businesses that collect the tax in the city. The seat is currently filled by Melody
York, who desires reappointment. The other seat has been filled by Fannie Coleman, who wishes to leave the authority after two terms as the original member. Ernie Wright has been a shadow member and is willing to fill her position. And at this time, I will turn to Mayor Pro Tem Lazaro, who's chairman of the authority board of directors, to make any nominations.
Thank you, Mayor. As you know, Ms. Fannie Coleman has been serving in that seat for since its inception, obviously, and she has been an absolute outstanding member of our committee. Ms. Fannie has indicated that she has some illnesses that she's dealing with, and she no longer is able to serve at this current time, so she can take care of herself, and she will very much be missed. We love Fannie, and we certainly applaud her service. Mr. Wright has been serving as a shadow member also during the time of its inception, and he has also been a very valuable member, Mayor, and I would recommend that we allow Mr. Wright to take that position if the council so chooses to do so. And also Melody York has been an instrumental member of the committee, and I also recommend that she be reappointed as well.
Okay. Are there any other nominations?
Mayor Phillips, I move that the nominations be closed and our candidates be accepted by acclamation.
Second. There's a second. Any other discussion? Hearing none, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Those seats are hereby filled.
Thank you.
That brings us to our reports for this evening, and I'm going to start with Mr. Willingham.
Thank you, Ms. Mayor. No report.
Mr. Bittner?
No report this evening.
Mayor Pro Tem Lazaro?
No report, Mayor. Thank you.
Ms. Washington?
No report, sir.
Mr. Thomas?
No report.
Mr. Warden?
Yes. Just a couple of comments. Looking at all the presentations tonight, I'm reminded what a great community we live in, and I'm always amazed at all the hard work that goes into all these various organizations. Those committees work hard to promote all these various events, and of course, the citizens of Onslow County are very generous in their giving to support those events, and I just think it's great that we live in such a caring and generous community, and I'm very proud to be an Onslow County native. The last comment I had was the Fleet Reserve Association guys mentioned that they sold their reserve hall there off of Dawson Cabin Road, and 40-some years ago, I got married and had our wedding reception at the Fleet Reserve Hall. So
that's neat.
I appreciate the vision of those guys and all they've done for our country and for our community. And so it brought back some memories. So, and other than that, Mayor, I'm proud as always to be a part of this group and part of being part of Onslow County and Jacksonville.
Thank you, Mr. I don't have much to report. I did go this past Friday evening to the POW/MIA observance. It was a very nice ceremony. It was put on by the local chapter Rolling Thunder. It was very well attended. If you've never been, it's a great opportunity, a great service to attend. At least one time. You need to go. But that's all I have to report, Dr. Woodruff.
Mayor, no report other than thank you and the council for your continued support of your staff. I believe you saw in the annual report provided by the Director of Public Services that we are very well served by a wonderful group of employees. And we thank you and the council for the leadership you all give this community. Thank you.
No report, Mayor. Thank you. All right. With that being said, I would entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?